Hey there, friends. Happy Monday. Let's talk about some Bible study today. I hope you guys had a wonderful Father's Day this past weekend with your loves. And today we're just going to jump right back into Bible study with 1 Peter chapter 2. And we're going to be looking at just two verses, verses 11 and 12. So let me read those to you. Beloved, I urge you as sojourners and exiles to abstain from the passion of the flesh, which wage war against your soul. Keep your conduct among the Gentiles honorable, so that when they speak against you as evildoers, they may see your good works and glorify God on the day of visitation. So, two short verses here. Let me just bring something up here on my computer that disappeared. I think that's going to be gone. Oh, well. Hey, Tiffany. Good to see you. Happy Monday to you. So there's three things here in these verses that I wanted to point out to you, and that there's three roles that that Peter talks about us assuming for the Lord. The first one, of course, is that we are still, we've discussed this a couple of times, that this world is not our home. So we are exiles, we are pilgrims. And so pilgrims are on a journey to a spiritual journey to reach the heaven, just like we are. And so this world is not our home. So we are pilgrims. So it says, I urge you as sojourners and exiles. And then it says, to abstain from the passions of the flesh, which war against your soul. So in that second half of the verse, where it says that the passions of the flesh war against our soul, the word war implies military. It implies a soldier, that we're in a battle. And so even though we are, here on earth, we are still spiritually, we're part of God's army. And so we are warring and battling. And we never should forget that we are in a spiritual battle, that there's forces of good and evil that are fighting for our soul. And we have to fight. And we have to fight to maintain our lives pure and to stay putting the word in our lives so that we can live pure lives. Because when we give into those things which they call passions of the flesh, then we can destroy our inner man, not just our physical body. It can impact our physical body, but it can also impact our inner way that we think, the way that we discern, the way that we make judgment. All of those things that can impact our peace and our well-being. And so it's important for us to say no to those things that can really destroy us. Things that maybe the world doesn't really think are bad, but the Bible says that we should be careful and we should stay away from those things because we're yielding to the Lord instead of yielding to our own selfishness. So that's really what we're talking about here in verse 11. In verse 12, he says, keep your conduct among the Gentiles honorable, so that when you speak against, so when they speak against you as evildoers, they may see your good deeds and glorify God in the day of visitation. So this really has to do with our citizenship and also with our witness and the idea that our lives are what are like a real huge billboard for the Lord. And so we are called to make wise choices, to do the right thing. And as we continue to persevere in doing what's right, even when maybe people are speaking badly of us or persecuting us, then we continue to point to the Lord and we show that our faith is strong and real and that God is who he says he is. And so that's really the three things that Peter is talking about here in this passage. The first thing is, you know, we are his beloved. We're God's beloved, but we are on a journey. We're on a journey and we are persevering through difficult times to come to greater intimacy with him. We're moving towards him. We're moving towards heaven. This world is not our home. So we shouldn't get comfortable here and build all our treasure here. We're supposed to be moving our treasure towards heaven. And so our desires and our focus and everything should be spiritually looking forward and looking up to God. And then the second thing is that the passions of the soul those carnal things that are, you know, that tell us to give in to our own our own gluttony and our own sensuality and our own, and to do what makes us feel good rather than what necessarily God says to do, those things really end up destroying us. And so they war against the soul. And so he's telling us here that we need to put our armor on and we need to remember we're in a spiritual battle. And then the third thing is that we are a witness and that we are to conduct ourselves in an honorable way and we are to have good citizenship by, you know, doing what's right, even when other people don't. And so we might be heading in one direction and everyone around us might be heading in a different direction. And maybe people are putting us down and, you know, trying to get us off game and telling us that we're not doing the right thing, but we know that we're following what God says and that we're doing what's right, that we are, you know, we're treating others well, even if they're not treating us well, and that we are loving our brother as Christ would have us to love our brother. All of those things point to God and show our good deeds glorify him. Here at the end, it says that they'll see it on the day of visitation. And it's not really clear what the day of visitation is. It could be the last day when Jesus returns for us. It could be the judgment day. But whatever it is, it's going to be a day where there will be a reckoning. There will be a recognizing of the fact that that God is who he says he is. Because sometimes people won't see that until they're face to face with their maker. So I just want to encourage you for these really two simple verses that we have a role that God has called us to. And so for these verses, as his beloved, we've got to remember this world is not our home. We're pilgrims here. That's an ongoing theme here in the book of 1 Peter. And I think this is the third time we've seen it. And the second thing is we've got to remember we're in a spiritual battle. We've got to wage war against those things, those fleshy things that destroy us. That might make us happy today, but in the long run, they're going to keep us away from drawing closer to God and knowing who God is. And then the third thing is we've got to remember that we're here to be a witness. So even when people are putting us down and where they're telling us that we're not doing the right thing or that we're goody-two-shoes or that God is not real, we need to just keep loving them. We need to keep doing, stay in your lane. Know that that's what God has for you, that you need to persevere in doing what he says is right. And then in the end, on the day of visitation, they'll know that God is who he says he is. So simple study today, just two quick verses. Next week, we're going to look at verses 13 to 17. So I hope you'll read ahead and you can download the Fuel Your Quiet Time handout. I don't have it to show you today. I misplaced my hard copy and I had a copy up on my laptop, but my laptop went dead. So I just want you to know that you can go to the blog as a subscriber. You can fuel that. You can download that. And then you can write down four things about the passage, just what you observe in it. And you can talk about what you, how you can apply that to your life. And then you can just linger with the Lord and ask him to make those things really fruitful in your life. So four quick things, just a quick handout to help you with Bible study. It's the Fuel Your Quiet Time handout, and it's free to you as a subscriber to the blog, along with many, many other goodies in the Faith Fuel Library. So I hope it will be an encouragement to you. Hey, Claudia. Hi, Carla. Hi, TV. So just thank you for joining me here. If you're joining me live, this is a really short Bible study, but we'll be back next Monday at 2 p.m., so I hope you'll join me. Tag your friends underneath this post if you think it'll be an encouragement to them. And we'll be here every Monday for just a few. Hey, Jackie, thanks for joining me here at the end of the study. We'll be doing just a few verses every week of 1 Peter chapter 2. And you can catch all the former videos on my YouTube page, which you can subscribe to as well, and catch up if you've missed any. Okay? God bless and have a great day.